So a question that I get a lot from people and that I see a lot of people posting is, should you do agency work for free? Especially if you're just starting out, this is a question that I see all the time. Should you do work for free or should you charge? Now, I know that there's a lot of opinions about it. I'm gonna tell you what I think is best, and I'm gonna tell you why I think it makes so much sense to do free work. So there's the answer right there. You should do free work. I'm gonna tell you why you should and how to use the free work that you do to get more of your ideal clients. So let's get into this video. Hey everybody, my name is Brandon Brashears. I do daily digital marketing videos here. So if you are trying to grow your brand or your business with digital marketing, then be sure to subscribe. If you have an agency or if you have a brand where you're trying to get clients, this is going to be a really helpful video. So this is in my experience in digital marketing, but if you do anything, whether it's if you do video production, you're trying to get clients that do videos, or you do photography, or you do anything in the world, you can apply this advice to that. So people will say, should I do work for free when I'm starting out? And I think the answer is 100% yes, you should. But there's a caveat, you shouldn't do it for everybody. So you need to identify the right kinds of people. I'll tell you who those are in just a second. So if you don't have any experience, or if you don't have any clients that you can use as track records, or if you don't have a portfolio to show people, you need to build up that experience. You can't just jump out into the marketplace and say, hey, I'm new here, I have tons of, I've got skills, hire me please, because I'll help you, right? It doesn't matter how much you have as far as education, if you don't have the experience and you don't have the results proven, it's difficult to get jobs. Now, if you think about it from a traditional standpoint, if you went to college and you got a degree, you know everything for that degree, theoretically, right? Even when you get into the first job, you're not into an executive level, high paying job. You typically still have to work your way up. And the same thing goes with doing digital marketing, doing agency work, being a freelancer. You need to get a client base with testimonials, social proof, and a track record. So how do you do that? I think that giving out free work to very strategic people, number one, you need to choose maybe a few different niches to see where you like working. So this is for anything. If you are a digital marketer and you want to work with restaurants or chiropractors or doctors, or you want to do e-commerce ads, or you want to do service ads, or you want to do Google pay-per-click, or you want to do SEO, you need to pick something to get really good at. You need to have mastery of that. Once you have mastery of that specific topic or subject, then you go out and you get clients. Now, the way that I like to get clients when I was starting out is I would do things on a trial basis. So I'd find somebody that I knew either through referrals, word of mouth, through podcasts, through putting out content. People would respond and ask questions, and from there you can build relationships. But if somebody needs some help, back when I didn't have a track record, I'd say, hey, how about I go ahead and I do X, Y, and Z, and I'd have a very well laid out plan. I'd say, here's what we can expect we're going to be getting. Here's what we're going to be shooting for. We'll test it out and try it out. If it works, then number one, can I document the results? Very, very important that you document your results. Number two, could I get a testimonial? And number three, if you'd like to continue working with me on an ongoing basis, could I offer a proposal to you? And so that does a few things. First, you need to have track record. It's very helpful to sell, you know, to a specific niche, especially if you're targeting a niche of a product or service that's duplicatable. You can continue to sell ongoing. It's great to have a track record and say, here's my work for this. Here's what you can expect. If you're going to a dentist, you want to know that they've done the procedure that they're doing, right? If you're going to even a hair salon, you want to see that they've done good haircuts, right? So that being said, you need to have something that you can show. And so number two, I said document. You need to be able to document the work that you're doing. Using your work as a case study that you can then use as a lead magnet to attract more of those ideal clients and customers is extremely helpful. And so don't underestimate the power of using, you know, past results for lead magnets, pulling out specific insights, giving specific examples and case studies. You know, I'll give you some examples really quick. So if you say, for example, I'm going to come in and I'm going to start taking over the AdWords that you're doing and you're a chiropractor. Chances are if somebody set up AdWords, especially if they have AdWords Express, right, they've gone and they've set all of the default settings and they're wasting tons amount of money. So you could go in day one and say, hey, look, it, we're fixing this, this, and this. It's resulted in this much in decreased in ad spend that's being wasted. right off the bat, we're saving them 50% of their ad spend, and then we're getting them better results with the rest, right? So that's very, very helpful. And then the third caveat is, hey, let me earn your business. I want to do a good job for you. If I'm doing a good job for you, would you agree to pay me for the work ongoing? So they've been able to put their toe in the water, dip their toe in the water, test you out, see how it goes. If they like the work, it's only a win situation for them. Now, I will say that it's important to be approaching these people in a specific way. If you just go out and you're blind, you know, shotgun approach of saying, hey, I'll do social media work for you for free, and your messaging pages and stuff, that's probably not going to work. And I'll tell you why. First, that the thing that most brands and businesses, they're afraid of, number one, losing time, number two, losing money, and number three, having poor results, right? So there is some risk, even if you're going to do the ad spend, which I totally wouldn't suggest that you do ad spend, but make sure that you have enough context. I'm going to create another video, if you click up here in the left-hand corner, once it's finished, it's going to talk about how to approach businesses to get them so that they will want to work with you and your agency. If you're trying to grow a business, if you want to do digital marketing, be sure to comment below. Let me know what your email address is. I'm looking for more people to work inside of my agency. I do both AdWords and Facebook. So if you're trying to grow your brand or your business, if you would like some agency work, comment below. I'm happy to help out and set up some kind of an agreement with us so that we can both grow our agencies and get closer to our goals. I hope you enjoyed this video. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you on the next one.